Today, the 31st coronation anniversary celebrations for Kaba Coronary Munda Mutebi II kicked off at St. Paul's Cathedral in Namirembe with crowds who came to give thanks and pray for the king. Today's unorthodox occasion involved royalty as more than 1,000 guests packed inside the church, but it was a draw away from the traditional outdoor celebrations, usually steeped in ancient Buganda beliefs and cultural sites around the kingdom's 18 counties. The prayers were led by the Bishop of Namirembe Diocese, Right Reverend Moses Banja, and Most Reverend Dr. Stephen Samuel Kazimba Mugalu, the Archbishop of the Church of Uganda. Bishop Banja also spoke about the great accomplishments of the Kabaka for the past 31 years. He highlighted efforts made by the Kabaka to extend social services to communities, especially health services, mobilized through the annual bath run. Uganda Prime Minister Charles Peter Mayiga also attended service, in addition to a host of clan chiefs, clergy and political heads, including lawmakers and Kampala Minister Minsa Kabanda, who represented the Prime Minister Rabinani Nabanja.
Mu myaka asatu mugumu nga namunswala mula ye mwene n'Obuganda bwonna buyise mu bizibu n'ebisoomooza ebiwerako okuzzaawo Obwakabaka kwalimu okufunvu okutuddiza ebimu ku bintu byaffe wabaddewo kalumanywera obutaweebwa federo kukyali kusoomooza tulina abeefunyiridde okuleetawo enjatika mu Buganda ate n'okutyoboola ekitiibwa kyaffe ekyatusobozesa okuddamu okuba Obwakabaka.
Mayiga reiterated his condemnation of undisclosed individuals and groups aiming to destroy Uganda. Kabaka and Mwenda Mutebi II, who addressed the gathering remotely from his Nkoni Palace, expressed gratitude to God and the doctors who have taken care of him. He said that he is steadily improving, although he was unable to appear physically at the anniversary on doctor's orders.
Naye olw'embeera n'ebiragiro by'abasawo tetusobodde kubeegattako nga bwe gubeera bulijjo. Embeera gye tuyiseemu mu myezi egiyise eviiriddeko abantu abamu mu butamanya oba mu bugenderevu okuvoola n'okumenya empisa y'ensi n'okweyisa mu ngeri etusaanidde.
Kabaka emphasized the need for unity among his subjects and sticking to the Buganda culture norms. Uganda Police Force has backed the proposal to impose a time limit within which alcohol is sold in Uganda, but asked Parliament to strengthen the provision by imposing higher taxes on bars to control the mushrooming bars established everywhere in the country and to encourage the consumption of alcohol at home. The proposal was made by James Ochaya, the Deputy Inspector General of Police, while appearing before Parliament's Joint Committee of Health and Trade to submit the force's views on the Alcoholic Drinks Control Bill 2023, which was tabled in August 2023 by Sarah Openly, the woman member of Parliament for Toro District. Police also wants controls to be put in place for online alcohol sellers, which he says end up selling alcohol to minors. He further proposed that the law criminalizes anyone who sells alcohol to any police officer in uniform. Police also proposed an amendment that shall criminalize any security officers from entering any bar while armed.
Our justification is to discourage opening of bars anywhere and encourage consumption of alcoholic drinks from home settings.
Legislators were, however, concerned about the proposed amendment of encouraging alcohol consumption from home, saying that it could increase domestic violence as well as expose minors to alcohol.
The justification, therefore, is to check abuse of online alcoholic trading among children who may be using SIM cards registered in their parents' or guardians' names.
Section 14 of the Alcoholic Drinks Control Bill 2023 states that a license shall not sell an alcoholic drink or native liquor before 17 hours and after 22 hours on working days and 12 hours and after 00 hours on public holidays and weekends. court in Kampala today has delivered judgment for the seven Chinese nationals for carrying out drilling activities in the Rela wetland. The group was convicted upon its plea of guilty, although they had previously pleaded not guilty, reasoning that they were just tourists. Today they appeared for a judgment hearing before the Machi India Best Chief Magistrate's Court of Standards, Utilities and Wildlife, presided by Gladys Kamasanyu. The convicts are Liang Chengwu, Wei Wenhu, Lian Cheng Ziyang, Ha Dongshu, Shi Gongzu, Gi Xingliang, and Wang Piechuan. They pleaded to the charge of conspiracy and disturbing a wetland by drilling contrary to the Ugandan law. In the judgment read out by Chief Justice Gladys Kamasanyu, each of the accused has been ordered to pay 30 million shillings as a fine for drilling in the wetland and 10 million shillings for conspiring to serve a jail term of 4 years.
Each of the convicts, each man,
each
is sentenced to a fine of 30 million Uganda shillings only, in default of which each convict will serve an imprisonment term of 1 year.
Prosecution states that on July 8, 2024, at Kamuunga Village, Magezi Kizungu Parish, Lokaya Town Council, in Kalungu District, the group, along with others still at large, allegedly disturbed the Rela wetland system by drilling in a manner likely to have adverse effects on the wetland. It is further alleged that the group carried out illegal activities without any approval from the National Environment Management Authority, NEMA. The seven Chinese investors were arrested by National Management Authority officers together with Uganda's Environment Police.